Thank you, sir. Now, dear girls, are you hungry?
No, sir.
If you are hungry, now you will be fed up. By the mostly eager or incomparable or precious speech by our honorable, for whom we are eagerly waiting for here. Now I would like to invite our honorable sir, our captain, for our principal sir. Please, sir. Please come here and please, sir. Please speed up.
Thank you, everybody. I don't have any, I'm a father, I don't have any daughter. I have two sons. But my wife is so unhappy because she doesn't have any daughter. Daughter is very, very precious for his family. And this is a station, this is a session. Very enjoyable, very good. Exactly, we're trying to do something as regards to English here in Police and Instrument College. We want that I just two or three days back I talked to our president, Mr. Kurisubarampo. I told him that we are making a regulation in Police and Instrument College. And give me time just 6 months. And all the students here will speak English very fluently. We want to see that we have already declared one day of the week, that is Saturday, a day of English speaking day. Please don't speak a single word in Bangla on that particular day. It is Saturday. Saturday. Speaking English is not that much difficult. It is easy, but you have to practice it. I have told you repeatedly, many occasions have just faced you and told you that English speaking is not at all difficult. It is very, very easy as speaking in Bengali. But you will have to try hard and have many practices. Just practice English. There are so many things in English. Writing, listening. Listening is very difficult. As far as I am concerned, listening to me is very difficult for the broad scales of English. Writing is easy. To me, reading is very easy. Speaking is not that much difficult for me. But I cannot follow. The listening is to me is very, very difficult. And this is a very important thing. Listening is very important. How to do develop a listening skills? You just have a movie here, sitting, and you just see the movie at home. Just English, there are so many channels of English channels here on the TV. You just follow. There's, of course, some techniques, and we'll describe the techniques too in some other day. How listening can be a systematic thing for you. How listening, you can improve your listening. But first time, you just watch the TV programs in English. At the beginning, programs of Bangladesh or India, does not native English speakers. And then you switch to British English, American English, and English of other countries. British English, I think, it is very, so far I'm concerned, it is the best one. I try to speak in BBC pronunciation style for the styles of BBC, and that is the best, I think. Just try. Okay. Here, this particular occasion, about the girls and the boys. Our colleague has said that most of the students who secured first 10 positions, at least 9 is girls. Very busy, very good. But we want to bring our boys also in this field. Our girls is far more advanced than boys. I don't know what the reason. It may be that our boys are that much serious and the girls are so much serious. Our cultural programs are dominated by girls. Even everything, debate, our literary projects, all are dominated by the girls in this police school college. But our 50% of the students, more than 50%, 60 to 70% students are boys. We'll have to bring the boy in this things, so that they can improve them on these laws. We'll try and try and try. We'll always keep trying these things, that there should be one thing. What we'll have to do is just create an environment here. Okay? Just create an environment in the school and at your house, at your home if possible. Please tell your father and mother and brother, sister to speak, to encourage them to speak in English. Not every day, sometimes. So that there is an environment, very functional environment. And that environment will help you to have your English speaking developed. And one day, that Saturday, I was just giving our English teachers the particular responsibility that no students, especially the students in their classes, English classes at least, they should speak utter a single word in any other language than English. English has so many things to do. Just simply speaking English is not enough. You must have to speak correctly and with very good pronunciation. I have already taken many classes of pronunciation. I will go on, I'll keep on praying, just taking classes. Which class do you belong? All these girls from different classes.
Novum 9 and 10.
I will take classes here, I will take good classes, and I will give particular importance in pronunciation, English pronunciations. English pronunciation is very, very important, because if somebody is selected to go to, there is then a chance to go abroad in these programs. If somebody, you have been selected and you have the chance to go to USA. Their pronunciation is somewhat different from the British pronunciation. Still, if you don't correctly pronounce what you are going to say, they will not understand. And what they will say, you will not understand. Because English pronunciation, there are such particular rules of pronunciation. There are some traces of the English pronunciation. Some words are there. You must have to know how to just add the words, how to pronounce the word. Therefore, pronunciation must have to learn pronunciation. And another thing, there are two things in English. One is informal English and another is formal English. Formal English is that English we are just in a formal gatherings, a seminar or a very important gathering of the elite persons. And in that, it being conducted by the formal English. But just we are talking with you in your house, I'm talking my students, I must have to say it in formal English. If I say, will you please mind to shut the door? It's the formal English. And people will laugh and ridicule you if you always say the formal English. You must have to learn the informal things of the formal English. And that will happen. Just in common conversation, you must have to take up the informal English. Then you have to know this difference between formal and informal English. All these things will be taught in the class. I will take utmost care. I told our president that you just wait and see, give me 6 months' time, and at least some sizable percentage of the students will be very fluent, they will be very comfortable in speaking English, and will create an example in whole of town that our police school has always. We are very compassionate. So thank you very much. I have very amused. I'm very, it's really very good. The way you talk, you just spoke here. Many of the students just spoke in a very clear voice. Their conversation was quite good, and they are so much fluent. Thank you. Congratulations, Deputy Party. And don't look back. It is time to look forward. All the girls and the boys, especially the girls. Girls are very ill-treated now in the society. It's very bad. Girls are the same person, they have the same merits, everything they have. But our environment is not conducive to for going forward for the girl students. There are so many problems outside, and those impedes you, that obstructs you to be at the boys. And that days will be over, that days will be done, and the days are coming for the girls to have their own time there. So thank you very much, and it's a very enjoyable session here, and I'm feeling very, very happy that I come here and I talk before you, and I have seen that what you have done here is wonderful. Very, very good indeed. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving a nice time, precious time, sir. And sir, pray for us that we will be always grateful to you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
I would like to give extra thanks to our honorable principal sir. He has told us that he will take your class on pronunciation, which is very much important for us. I would like to give him extra and cordial thanks to our sir. And he has taken many classes, which are very much important for us. And he will take, and he will come again, I think. And he is very much interested. And now we will finish. We have two PowerPoint presentations for you, but I think we have no need to that presentation because you have told everything here. Just one point I would like to give you some one advice only. So the advice is cyberbullying. You are the girls, you use different social media, Facebook, Viber, WhatsApp, Messenger, and etc. So if you use them, just you will be sure that you will not share your password to anybody. And you will make your accounts very much safety, secure, so that nobody can make any disturbance in your accounts. So this was the number one information in my presentation. So this was the main point, that if we use any social media, so as you are the girls, you may do attack with the cyber crime. So you will be aware about this, and you will go ahead, you will speak up, you will never give up. Today, our today's forum is, please, with me you will do it. Our today's forum is, we will always speak up. Please do like me. We will speak up. We will never give up. So thank you very much. And now we have a photo session. It is very much important. So now we will go to the before our I think auditorium. On the baranda auditorium we will do a photo session and then you will go. But we have announcement where you are presented here. Now you will go home, you will write down an impact story. What you have learned from this session, what experiences you have gathered, you will write down. You will give one of your photo and your roll number and class. So then you will give it to me on the coming Thursday and I will send it. So thank you very much. And I would like to request our principal sirs and assistant sirs and Babaji sir also to attend the photo session. Thus we will take a photo session, then our program will be finished. So thank you very much.